thank God that when I was a young Christian, I opened this book. Oh, I thank God I loved this book. Thank God I read this book. Even when I didn't understand, I read it and read it and read it, trusting the Holy Spirit to open it to me. I thank God that He soaked my life at a young age in His Word. When the false came, I knew what was false and I knew what was real because I had been soaked in this book. I knew the difference. We are to present our lives as a living sacrifice. Yield our lives to the purposes of God. We can say like Paul, I am crucified with Christ. That means my will, my plans, my ambitions, but nevertheless, I live. And yet not I, but Christ lives in me. Paul goes on to say, I live this life by the faith in what Christ did for me. That's the source of my life. I've come to Christ because I have faith in what was purchased for me on Calvary, and I trust God to give me the life that He has promised me. We have got to lay our lives down for the purposes of God. This is not a Sunday school picnic, the Church of Jesus Christ. This is not an invitation to have continuous good times. This is a war for the souls of men. Beloved, listen to me like you've never listened to me ever in your life. I speak from a heart of passion. I condemn no one. My mind is forever branded with the story that I heard of police officers from the city of New York as people were fleeing from a crumbling building. There were police officers and firemen and others that were running towards the building saying, run for your life at their own peril. And in some cases, I believe they knew they were going to die, but there was a sense of duty. I was crying out to God. I said, God, don't let my sense of duty be less for your kingdom than these beloved firemen and policemen were for those that are perishing in the falling tower. We're living in a generation when truth is falling into the streets. I want to be among those that are not running away from the conflict, but running into the conflict and saying, run for your life. The Apostle Paul, he says, what agreement is the temple of God with idols? You are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and will be a father to you, and you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. Touch not the unclean thing. Come out from among them. Run for your life. Because this is about your life. It's not just about an opposing theology or a conflicting viewpoint on Jesus. This is about your life. Beloved Church of Jesus Christ, I know tonight I'm speaking not just to Times Square Church, but there'll be churches all over North America, in particular the United States and Canada, that are going to hear this message. Beloved Church, get away from their altars. Run for your life. Run from gospels that focus only on success and prosperity. Run! Run from those who use the name of Christ only for his personal gain. Run from those that are picking your pocket in the name of Jesus. Run! Run from gospels that only focus on self-improvement. How can I... 3 steps to a better personality. 3 steps to this and for... Run! Run from churches where men and not Christ are glorified. Run! Run! Body of Christ, run! Get out! Don't touch the unclean thing. Run from churches in America and Canada where there is no Bible. There's no cross in the theology. There's no soul-searching word. There's no repentance from sin. There's no mention of the blood of Jesus. Run! It's unclean. Run! Run from churches where the worship leaves you cold. There is no sense of God because they don't know God. Run! Run from churches where you're comfortable in your sins. If you come into the house of God and you've got sin in your life and you're not convicted of it, you're at a table of devils. Run from pulpits that are filled with political men who are using the pulpit of God for a personal political agenda. Run! Run from those who preach divisions between races and cultures. Run! Run! Get out! Turn it off! Get away from it! They know nothing of God. Run from ungodly, spasmodic movements and endless, empty prophesying. Beloved church, run for your life. Run from preachers that stand and tell stories and jokes. Run like you've never run before. Run for those that are only after your money. And they use one gimmick after another, one foolish thing after another to get your money. Run. They know nothing about the covenant-keeping power of God. They know nothing about the surrendered, crucified life. They know nothing about the Holy Spirit coming and enabling a man or woman to live for God, because that's not the focus of their message. Run! Run for your life!
I pray for you, church. Almighty God, you deliver your bride. Oh, God. Don't let the heathen rule over your house. Deliver your church. Oh, God, deliver your ministry. Deliver those who have genuinely been called of you. God, deliver them. Oh, God, in this last hour of time, help us to get back. I've poured out my heart. There's nothing more I can do, Lord. Oh, God, you have to go after this apostate church, this generation, Lord, of apostate. You've got to go after them, Lord. You've got to set your people free. All I can do is warn, but they've got to run. They've got to run. Beloved, pray for the church. Pray for the church of Jesus Christ. We repent, Lord, of our longings for prosperity and our longings for comfort. We repent, Lord, of our longings for a life of ease and our desire to put away the cross and put away the blood and put away the word and put away repentance. We repent. We've sinned against you, God, as a church. Shane, we've sinned against you, Lord. We see the judgment on the nation and we've been blind to the judgment that's in your house. Oh,